Hello, everybody. I have this really, really good pair of vintage speakers, as you can see here. Lafayette Criterion. Doesn't get any better than that. I'm going to move this box back a little. So maybe I could, like, manage to get that bottom woofer. So, like, yeah, as you can see, there's two. They're stacked on top of each other. I'm just going to play Bass I Love You by Basstronics. These things are 8 ohms, pretty much, these things are taking full power from the amp right now. So if I ever wanted to blow these, which I'll never will, yeah, so if I ever wanted to blow these, I probably can't. Because, like, just look at it. They're just refusing to die. Even at a volume 77. Max is 80. So that beautiful excursion. From here. So you could buy a pair of these off of eBay. I recommend you do. They're like $150. Sound awesome. Work great. And my dad says they're sitting in the attic for like 20 years, which I really don't understand why such a great speaker would be sitting up there for so long. I have vintage Genesis, it might be vintage, but I have a Pinnacle. If any of you know more about speakers than I do, and you think, and if you know that Pinnacle, is a really old brand of speakers, please comment that below, because that would be very helpful of you. So yeah. Like, subscribe, the song's Bass I Love You, once again. So yeah. Hopefully you enjoyed this. Cool, some cold still. Actually a little warm. Seems that all the vintage speakers have like a lot of excursion. As you can see here. It's a lot of excursion. I'm just gonna play one last song. This is thought it was a drought by Future. No, it's not the one.
I went to California and met a fellow by the name of Jack Morgan. We tried to think up a drink for Smirnoff Vodka with ginger beer. We came up with the name Moscow Mule. Just how it originated, I don't know. But I imagine that it had to do with a kick.
Yeah, and also shout out to Smirnoff from, like, those drinks. These speakers are about to go hard.
Get your
Plus the bass from those woofers are very rusty. I heard Lafayette went out of business, which I don't see why. Maybe they underpriced their speakers for the quality they are. Yeah. Which I don't see why, because this would be the last speaker company I'd want to see go out of business.
Drought.